On this week's Q&A, we're talking about why you should not be putting in offers on things that you actually can't afford. Hey everyone, and welcome to this week's Q&A. Hope you had a good week. Thanks for coming back. Okay, so today we're going to talk about why you shouldn't put offers in on things that you can't afford. One of the things we hear as realtors all the time from our buyer clients is, we really like this house and it'll probably go over our budget, but let's just put an offer in anyway. We'll see what happens because you never know. That is really the worst attitude that you could have, and I'll explain why. But the first thing I want to point out is that your realtor does know, or at least they should know, but they do know what a property should sell for. And when you think you never know what the price will be, they should know. That's our job. We run the numbers, we have a good indication, and you may not win every offer, don't get me wrong, but you have to have a good chance. So if you're not in the ballpark, don't waste everybody's time. And why is that? Well, number one, it is a huge time waster. It's a huge time waster for you, for the realtor, both realtors involved, for the seller. You know, why bother? It's a lot of work for everybody if you have no chance. And the second thing is that if you have no chance, you have just contributed to overinflating the price of that property, and you will eventually price yourself out of that neighborhood. So let's just take an example. We've got a house listed for $899. Everybody knows from the comps that that house should sell for over $1 million, and you only have $950 in your budget, but you decide, okay, why not? Let's just give it a go. Well, now we've got, you know, maybe 2, 3, 4 offers extra in on that property from people like you who are saying, you never know, let's try. That raises the price up. It's pretty simple. So instead of there being 4 good offers, right, people who really feel like they can compete, you've now got, you know, 8, 9, 10 offers from a bunch of people who have no shot at it. But the 4 people now who really have a shot have just spent more money to get the house, and the price of the house goes up. And that's part of the reason why we're in the situation we're in right now. The more offers there are, the higher the prices are going. And so I'm not telling you don't try for a house that you think you have a shot at, but I'm telling you, make sure your realtor knows and read the market and understand the comps to know that you actually have a chance, right? Don't just throw it in because you want to give it a try. It won't work, and it's just contributing to the problem. So that's my rant for today. If you have any questions, you know how to reach us. We always appreciate it if you like our content and share it with others that are interested. And of course, you can always follow our podcast, the Real Estate Show, Toronto Real Estate Show with Janelle and Leslie. That would be great as well. You can find that on Apple Podcasts or wherever you subscribe to your podcast. Thanks so much, everyone. Look forward to seeing you soon. Have a great day.